Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Perhaps this is your first time tuning in and joining us. We extend a warm welcome to you and trust that you're blessed with what you hear today. We want to begin with prayer. We want to pray for the direction of our nation. We want to continue to pray for our local region and community. We want to remember Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. And lastly, we want to remember our brothers and sisters around the globe. Perhaps you have a special unspoken request. It's a perfect time to make that known unto God. Let's pray together. Father, we love you. We praise you. We worship you. We thank you for allowing us to be a part of what you're doing in the earth in this age. Father, we pray for the direction of our nation. We pray that the Word, the Spirit, and the Church of the Living God can affect the direction of this country. We also pray for our local region and community and pray that you open up doors of utterance. We also pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. We pray that you'll continue to open up the windows of heaven and pour out your virtue and your power. And lastly, we remember our brothers and sisters around the world and pray that you build a hedge of protection around each and every one of them. We ask all this in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ, and everybody said amen. I want to direct your attention to Isaiah chapter number 51 and verse number 1. Isaiah chapter number 51 and verse 1. Hearken to me, ye that follow after righteousness, ye that seek the Lord. Look unto the rock whence ye are hewn, and to the hole of the pit whence ye are digged. Remembering the pit in which we were dug. Remembering the pit. Remembering the pit. Every once in a while, I think it is healthy. I think it is spiritually normative that we allow our minds to go back and to remember some things, not sin, not the involvement with sin and not the engagement of sin, but to remember the condition that we were in, to remember the condition in which God found us, to remember where we were when we found truth. For me, this easily can become a very emotional kind of a situation. More often than not, it is a very emotional time for me. In fact, just today, I heard about the passing of a man, one of the very first, he was the assistant, one of the assistants at the Rock Church when I got saved approximately 37 years ago. He passed away last month. I just heard about it. And I felt a sense of emotion about that because it caused my mind to go back to my very early beginnings at the Rock Church. This is an extremely emotional time for me. And when I remember the condition that I was in when I found truth, when I discovered truth. God used other people. And God used other people to bring truth to me. But when my eyes were opened and progressively, as I began to connect the dots, and my eyes were progressively opened to the truth, it was an amazing thing, an absolutely life-changing, amazing situation. I think it's also very important that from time to time that we count our blessings. You know, We're living in the 21st century. We're dealing with the prince of the power of the air. He is manifested through the media. He's manifested in this world. You don't even have to have a television in your home. You don't even have to go out to the bars and the nightclubs and be on drugs and go to movies. You don't have to be a part of any of that. And you can still feel the spiritual turbulence that is in this day and in this hour. we're not careful, we'll just get caught up in that, and the mindset of just being caught up in how we feel all the time, and instead of reflecting on things that would cause us to reflect on principles like being thankful and being grateful. And I think it's a good thing to take time and remember the pit in which we were dug, because we have all come a long ways. And I also think, as I've already mentioned, I think it's very healthy to number our blessings. Just start thinking about your blessings. It may take you a little bit of rerouting in the circuitry of your brain to get there, but whatever you got to do, it's worth it, because when you get there, there's a refreshing element that comes with rehearsing your blessings. The fact that you and I are baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost, and we are saved, salvation, we have truth, we have the Holy Ghost, we have the Church of the Living God, we have one another, we have our families. I could go on and on. You could even get more subjective than that. We have our health, we have our sound mind, and everybody out there with a sound mind, say amen. Just, I think it's so healthy to put things in proper perspective from time to time. I've never been more busy between my ears. I'm just thinking all the time, and some things are compartmentalized, and some things have to be rated in terms of preeminence and importance, and some things have to be viewed through the lens of this is I'm pastoring, and this is pastoral. We're involved in this construction process across the street, and it's almost like I'm part of the management team of that over there, and I am in reality as the pastor. There's all these things, and it's a constant juggling act. You have the same things, might not be the same things I'm juggling, but you have things you're juggling, and we can get so caught up in the minutiae and the mundane of just juggling and making sure that we're juggling. I think it's healthy to remember the pit in which we were dug, because all of us, that includes you, you have come a long, long ways. Who would have thought that you would have made it this far, and that you would have come this far, and you are victorious? And then I think it's good for us to remember our blessings, number them. I thank God for my wife. I thank God for my children. I thank God for health in my body. I could go on and on and on. You get the point. God is great, and greatly to be praised. Just consider this a little stop on the road of life to help us adjust our thinking and put ourselves in these types of postures so we can be refreshed with being thankful and being grateful. God bless you all. Thank you for joining us. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow.